Hi there, my name's David Nash from the University of Brighton, and I'm here at Seaford Head Nature Reserve to celebrate International Geodiversity Day. Now, you might be wondering what on earth geodiversity means. Well, in its simplest sense, it covers the rocks, the minerals, the fossils, the soils, the sediments, the landforms, and also the natural processes that shape the landscape in any given area. And there's an important relationship between geodiversity and biodiversity, and you can see that very well at Seaford Head. So, for example, the chalk bedrock here breaks down to form relatively thin, poor soils, but those soils are absolutely perfect for sustaining chalk grasslands, which are an internationally recognised habitat. There are also patches of a very fine windblown sediment called lerss, which provides the perfect substrate for rare burrowing insects such as the potter flower bee. If you look at the cliffs behind me, you can see how marine processes maintain the vertical cliff profile, which provides nesting sites for birds like kittiwakes and peregrine falcons. And at the bottom of the cliffs, you can see how those same processes shape the shore platform that's visible at low tide, where you can find a wide variety of marine flora and fauna. So, as I hope I've showed, there's this real intimate relationship between the geodiversity of an area and its biodiversity, and you can't really conserve one without protecting the other. Now, if you want to know any more about geodiversity, I'd thoroughly recommend having a look at the website geodiversitysussex.org.uk, where you can find out loads more about our local geology and geomorphology. So thanks very much.